Hey guys, I'm Voilen and welcome to this update video of No Zero Days November. So for the whole month November, I worked every single day on GoZen or video editor made with Godot, and I made daily journals on the Discord page, so Discord server. If you want to read those journals, just go to the Discord server and go into the GoZen related channel, and there you can find all the day journals. In the beginning, I was planning to make daily videos, and then I started thinking about it's probably better to make weekly videos, and yeah, I made 2 videos in total, and from the 9th there have basically been no updates at all. And that's basically because I was working with the FFMPEG stuff, and that part of the editor is extremely important because that helps us to import videos and to render videos. The only problem is a lot of documentation and forum posts with like help articles when something does not work. They're all outdated, and the FFmpeg documentation itself, it's not very clear, and yeah, a lot of the deprecated functions. It was a very big pain in the truth. But finally, I got it working. Right now we can import videos and render videos. With one small catch, we cannot actually render out audio yet, because for that to work I kind of want to have the timeline first to make certain that it actually works properly. But that's a worry for later. So right now what you see on the screen is a new startup menu. It improved a little bit compared to before, because after I got the FFmpeg stuff done, I started working more on the overall structure of the GoZen project. And let's take a quick look at our project page, which you can find on the GitHub repo of GoZen, link in the description normally. So what have I been doing? I started going over every single part of the editor again. So far I finished the FFmpeg integration, I finished the start menu, I finished the main window, and I did some overall structural changes which I will talk about in my next live stream. The things I'm working on right now are the project manager and the editor layout. The project manager is basically how the data gets saved of each project and how it gets loaded. And the editor layout is basically making it kind of flexible of where you want to put certain pieces, like have your files in one place or move it to the other place if you want to. Probably does not make much sense right now, but will make more sense later on. And the things I still need to work upon for finishing version 1, because believe it or not, we are very close right now to actually having a working video editor, and I don't want to put like a specific deadline on it from when we will finally have a version 1, but I'm fairly confident that in Q1, Q2 of 2024 we'll have a working video editor. Although that working, it's probably going to be an alpha version, so there will be bugs, probably some things will break. And right now, it only works on Linux-related systems because I don't have a Windows system. I also don't have a Mac system, and unless somebody is willing to donate me enough money to buy a Mac, there will probably not be any Mac version, unless people using Mac want to help the project and get it working. The to-do list for version 1 includes transitions. I want version 1 to be mostly complete that I can actually edit my own videos with, and for that I need basic transitions, not anything special or amazing, just very simple transitions. Next up is startup improvements. There's still some things about the startup menu which I would like to improve, because right now you can only see the five most recent projects that you've been working on. A lot of things still need to change, and yeah. Next up is the file dialog, because right now I use the built-in one. It's not really great, it has a lot of things missing, and I kind of want to do something special with the file dialog system, which would help people greatly when using GoZen. The timeline is another big one. That's the biggest part that's left for me to finish before people can actually edit videos. The moment that the timeline is working, I just need to make the project view actually like work properly, and then people can actually put videos in, cut, paste, and render out videos. Still without audio, that's still something I need to work on as well, but a worry for later. The effects panel and the comment bar. The comment bar is something that I may not work on that quickly. That will probably be when we have an alpha version out. It's not a high priority right now. The media pool is basically the place where you will find all the files that you added to the project and all the global files which are accessible from all your projects that you work on in GoZen. The project view is basically the view of where your timeline header is right now. A render menu it kind of speaks for itself. The bug reporting with Google Forms is something that can be implemented very easily. It does not require that much work. And next up, I kind of want to give a quick sneak peek of how it actually works right now, because we have working video and we have working audio. So right now I just enabled it that audio and video will play at the same time. The video will just play by going through the dictionary of frames without taking frame rate into account. So this 11 second video gets played in like a second or two, and the audio gets played in normal speed. So yeah, let's open this test room and let's play so you can see that it actually works. The video is filmed on a camcorder with very low quality and it's kind of grayish, and the audio is also kind of bad because it was filmed with the built-in mic on the camcorder. So let's start. Normal camera audio of the camcorder without anything on top or attached. Yeah, I had the audio muted for a little bit. But yeah, audio importing works and video frames importing works. Now I only need the timeline to manage the actual frames that they don't all play at once with the audio staying behind. But yeah, demuxing files works. I will make a more detailed video of how this whole process works and how I got FFMPEG to work properly. Well, properly. A lot of improvements still need to happen, but my first GD extension actually works, and that's something I also want to make a video about, how I made my GD extension, because working with GD extensions, it's kind of difficult right now. I'm not certain in how much it can be improved, but the debugging, it requires effort, especially if you work with a separate library, because basically the error codes, there are none. Debugging, not really possible because it just crashes without leaving any traces of why it crashed. And that's probably just an FFmpeg stuff, an FFmpeg library thing, and not Godot or GD extension related. So I don't want to go too hard for GD extensions, but it was a stressful experience. But that's mostly to do with the library that I was using. And overall, how did I experience No Zero Days November? It was a good experience to actually get a decent amount of work done and to force myself to work on GoZen every single day. Since the challenge stopped, I've actually been working on GoZen for the past 4 days. So I have been working on GoZen non-stop, every single day since the beginning of November. My life right now is a little bit busy, especially this week of December. It's going to be a busy one. I probably won't be able to make any videos anytime soon, but I'll try. And another thing I really want to do for this channel is start uploading weekly, and that will probably start happening from January. I really want to have weekly videos because my channel is just flatlining the entire time. And before I stop this video, I really want to give one quick mention, and that's to the people who have donated to me and are monthly donators on Ko-fi. Without their support, I would not be able to invest this much time into creating a video editor in Godot or like work on all these YouTube related things, and it would make my stay at home dad life a lot more difficult because I basically don't have any other income right now. I really wanted to mention this because it really helps a lot and I really, really appreciate the support. You guys make it possible. And also a quick mention to my Discord server, because without their support from No Zero Days November, from all my journals that I posted, I don't think I would have been able to succeed in this challenge. It was basically because of the people talking to me every single day that I got more motivated to actually work on GoZen every single day, because it is a giant project. I have to learn a lot of different things. How videos work, how image formats work, because did you know pixel format for images is not the only one? You also have something called planner image formats, which work differently, and basically all video files are using something called YUV420p. And yeah, converting that was not fun. So yeah, thank you all for watching. I'm glad to say that GoZen has made very good progress, and that an actual release date for version 1 is getting closer and closer, and in a couple of months, maybe, you'll be able to edit your own videos with GoZen. So thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one. Join Discord and take a look at my Ko-fi page. Thank you all for watching, and bye bye. Oh no, I touched the lens again.